Hi, and welcome back to this YouTube channel. My name is Emelie. Today we're gonna create a card using a stamp set, of course, from Trinity Stamps called Bunny Burrow, and this is one of my favorites from the Bright Side release. And I decided to go ahead and stamp out and color a lot of the images in this set. You can see the coordinating dies here on screen, and I will use a wire snitcher or something it's called something like that, and just cut them apart. And I have cut a little mask so I can see exactly how to line up this large die. You don't have to do this, but I wanted to make sure that the window and the door cut perfectly, since these will be interactive parts of our card today. And actually the window I will adhere back later on so you can see how I did that. After cutting this out, you can see how it perfectly aligned everything and cut around the image. You can see the window here that we will pop back in place later on. And that is a fun feature, because in this die set for this stamp set, you can also find other pieces that you can combine. And here are some of the images that I also cut out. You can see it took me some time to color and cut out all of these images, and you can see that I have enough to create a lot of cards. But for today I will only create one, and maybe later on I will be back with another card using these really fun products. And as I said, this is one of my favorites from this release, so I am super excited about this. And I went ahead and decided to create a background for my card, and I wanted it to be a sunset background. So I went in with some purple and now some orangey yellow color, and all are distress inks. I love using distress inks with my blending buddies from Trinity Stamps. And the mask I'm using here, or the stencil I'm using here, I'm using to just mask off a bit of the outer edge, because I wanted this to be a one layer card, and to make sure that I don't have any hard edges on my card front here, since I'm no expert at making sure that it's a smooth transition. I'm always liking to splatter it so I cover up any mistakes that I did. So here I took a scrap piece of paper and I'm coating it with some gray markers, just to create like some depth inside of that little home for the bunny. I wanted it to look like a tunnel leading into a bigger place, if that makes sense. So I will cut off the exit parts here and I will adhere it down, and when I have adhered it, I will also cut off if I have any exit pieces hanging off. So I'm taking my long scissors here and just making sure that I'm carefully cutting around the image. And I will also take some purple tape here. I think I take purple tape, or you can take masking. Oh, sorry, I also cut a piece of the inside of the door. Since I colored it, I got some... You could see how I colored it to the inside, since I used Copic markers and I wanted to stamp a sentiment there. So I took a white piece of paper that I also cut out and adhered it to the inside, just to make sure that I will have a nice stamp sentiment. And you can see I took another sentiment that says hello there and stamped it to the inside. And now I'm taking some purple tape and I will adhere my window to this, and that makes sure that I have it here in place and that it won't fall off. So that is a tip as well. If you don't want a window to be cut out, you can always pop it right back in, and nobody I think will ever notice that you have cut it out. So I always like to lay down my images to the backgrounds to see where everything goes before I start committing and adhering everything down. So when I had done it, I started to use a combination of fun foam and liquid glue, and then I will just pop some of the images up and some will be adhered flat. And when I had done these, a couple of them, I will go in a different direction. You will see here in a second when I start to pair or yeah, it's, I think it's called that, everything apart. So now I teared some of this apart, and you can see I wanted this to look more like the ink blending that I did with Lucky Clover on my background here. So I thought the heel looked a little bit too green, and I wanted it to be a little bit more a minty green. So I colored in with my Copic markers again and fussy cut it out. The sentiment I had here before I did all of that, love you, is from an older envelope, or I should say bookmark with an envelope set. I will of course have it listed down below because I forgot the name. And before I adhere anything more, I coated some of these parts with some liquid sparkle. This is from Nuvo Glitter Pen. And also a white gel pen. I went in around all the images just to make sure they have some more depth and dimension. And you can see that the house, I think, was more fitting better with the background when I did it in lighter, or I should say more minty green colors than I did with the dark green, or that is my opinion anyway. So we are starting to get to the end of this video. I hope you liked this video. If you did, it would mean a lot to me if you could consider giving it a thumb up and subscribing to this channel. And we will be back really soon with another project. And until then, I hope you have a fabulous day. Bye!